Good evening. This is Strange Love, and I'm your host, Cami Chaos. Welcome, babies. Hi, everybody, and welcome. We're joined, as always, by Mr. Chaos, everybody.
Hello.
And my very, very special doppelganger guest, Ms. Cami Kelson.
Hi, all.
That was Cami. It wasn't me, though.
It was the other Cami.
Hey, Cami, oh, God, I'm so confused.
It's difficult. We were just discussing how we're not used to being around people named Cami, and how every time I say something to her and I feel the need to say Cami, I feel like I'm talking about myself in the third person.
Yeah. It's very odd. Every time I say Cami, I have to smile and I just feel creepy.
It's creepy. It's very creepy. That'll make it easier.
I'll make it better.
That's our champagne.
Spanish cava.
It's not really champagne. I lied. It's not from Champagne. But we wanted to ask Mr. Chaos. Mr. Chaos, as most of you probably know, his name is Mike. And I'm guessing there's a...
It is?
Oh my God, I've outed Mr. Chaos. His name is Mike. There's a lot of people named Mike, right? Have you noticed that?
Yes.
How do you deal
Actually,
with that?
Actually, I was born with the name Michael, not Mike.
Correct, but you don't go by Michael.
Yeah, much I go by a lot of things other than Mike.
Maybe. No, but really when people talk to you and their name is Mike, or if you're talking to someone whose name is Mike, how do you deal with addressing them? And thank you for the bucket.
I don't know. You pour the champagne while I like... Now, what was the question? How do I... What?
The question was, in the supermarket and
thank
someone
you,
Cami. Says... You're welcome. Someone says, hey, Mike, do you turn around?
Always.
This is the problem that I'm having today. When you're asking Cami for something, I feel like I need to get up and get you the oregano or whatever you're asking for earlier.
And
there's no oregano in the paella.
It wasn't oregano.
And we're getting along today, so it's not like, Cami!
I'm glad you weren't yelling at me. Yeah.
That would be fun.
That would be funny. I'd
love
like
to
that.
See you step up. You know, it's like, yeah, well, I don't know. If I knew where that pen was, Mike, I just got here.
I don't know where the calendar is.
Yesterday, exactly. Yesterday we were in Costco, and we're walking down the aisle with the detergent, and I pointed at a detergent. I said, no, that's the one I want. I need that one. And this guy that worked there walked up right behind me and looked at me funny and picked it up and put it in the cart for me.
That's because I was like, do we need these beans or whatever on the other aisle? And you're not paying attention to me and I'm paying attention to you. And this guy just like sort of fulfilled the request.
That was really funny. I was like, sorry. It wasn't you.
That's hilarious.
Thank you, guy.
Yes, mm-hmm. Thank you, guy at Costco for putting my soap in the cart for me.
He's probably like, okay, crazy. Demanding, a little demanding.
As your daddy Chaos would say, that man is whipped.
Yes,
he's fulfilling requests by other women.
By other women.
Exactly. Yeah. So Mike didn't really answer much of our question. He doesn't. You do turn.
He would turn.
How do you deal with addressing someone else with your name?
That's interesting. I have a work situation like that where I send emails back and forth, and I just put my last initial on it to help the confusion. And I noticed that in the email this guy sent back, he put his last initial too. It was kind of cute.
So he followed suit. It was cute. You would describe that work situation as cute.
Yeah.
Which leads to the name story.
Moving on.
Yeah, the name story. I said I'd say my name because it's difficult to get from reading. It's Canberra. Canberra. And I was named after a coastal city in California. When it was on fire, not really, it looked like it was on fire at sunrise. And that's that. And now we're going to move on to Christmas cards.
Moving on.
We have Christmas cards from some bloggers, and so we thought we'd say thank you. And the first one we received was from Mr. Fabulous.
Mr. Fabulous.
Yeah, no, colleague Vander Business.
So nothing about...
No, nothing offensive in this at
nothing
all.
Nothing offensive.
Just pictures of bunny rabbits, but I noticed that they're not his bunny rabbits, because I've seen his bunny rabbits on a pot on a video. Hmm. They're black. They're very cute. And then the next one is from Bubble Wench and Hubby Man.
Bubble
and look at that.
Oh, that's cute.
It's a little kitten. It should be on LOL Cats. Mr. Chaos loves LOL Cats. He would love it if they all went away.
Yes.
I love LOL Cats. And then the next one. See, this would make a better video.
Yes, it would.
No, that's fine.
It's sad.
But I'm enjoying watching you show the cards because I can see them.
I do my Vanna White thing. And the next one is from Sybil. And I won't read to you what she wrote because it's all very loving and touching and, you know, yeah.
All those,
anyway, it's a picture of Hilda in a wreath. Gilda? I don't know how to say the fictional name. I'm sorry.
I notice all the Gilda. I notice all the snarky bloggers send just these loving, outpouring, beautiful cards at Christmas.
They do. Like really warm and loving, loving love cards.
Like maybe they're ashamed of the year and they're trying to make up.
I wanted to mention Sybil for just a second because she told me to tempt you with chocolate.
She also said that you couldn't have paella until you dug 10 feet of the hole between her house and mine.
She's just very bitter about the situation.
Yes. Yeah, so if together, you don't, yeah, if you don't tempt me with chocolate, I won't make you dig a hole.
Okay, perfect.
Good. Sybil, you do not win. And the next one is from Lori at Fairy Tales and Margaritas and her four beautiful children. One of them looks like he's primed for a role as a young monk in a movie. I can't remember which order their names go in, Lori. I'm sorry. I'm a bad friend.
Nice card, though.
It is a beautiful card. It was very beautiful, and I knew exactly who it was from as soon as I saw it. And the last one is the most special and wonderful and heartfelt and touching of all the cards we received all year, not just from internet-related people, and it was from our ISP.
Yes, they sent a Christmas card, and they personally signed the card.
Yes, each member of the staff, let's see, we've got one in pink and one in blue and a different blue and a different blue and then two different blackish grays and a neon orange.
Best ISP in the world.
And wow. A neon pink, look at that. Did you get a card like that from your ISP?
I did not.
You have the wrong ISP.
I do. That's
you right. Should move to Portland and get our ISP.
I might.
Independent Portland ISP, the best ISP I've ever had. Not because they send Christmas cards, because they're good.
But you talked over Cammy.
Sorry.
Moving to Portland. I said you should move to Portland. And she said,
I might.
Oh my God, there might be two Cammy vloggers in the city of Portland.
What will they do?
Look at each other uncomfortably. Cause
not go to the store together, that's for sure.
That's
hey,
for
Cammy.
Sure.
No, the blogger. And you both look.
Oh. No, the black-haired blogger.
Oh.
With Converse.
Is wearing jeans and a black shirt.
With the black shirt.
Hey, yeah. Uncomfortable.
So how can we differentiate?
We need names.
We do.
Because it can't be Cammy K and Cammy K.
Mm-mm.
Because
now you all have seen Invasion of the Body Snatchers, right?
Yes.
I have never seen Invasion of the... It sounds too scary.
Yeah. So I'm wondering which one of you is the pod person.
Oh. She's pointing at me.
I can't be the pod person.
I don't want to be the pod person.
Yeah. Well, it's spelled differently. And her name is just, it's not just Cammy, but her name is Cammy. I didn't shorten my name. My parents did. But.
Mm-hmm. One of these pod people is making one a podcast right now.
One of these things is not like the other.
Bad joke.
I'm just Cammy.
Mm-hmm.
That could be my name.
Just Cammy.
Cammy.
Mm-hmm. Or we could find a way to...
But you know, people do that have visited your blog first and then come to mine, call me the other Cammy.
Oh, do they?
Mm-hmm.
Aww.
Oh, but then I'm not offended by it. It's okay. The other Cammy.
The other Cammy.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm.
I don't know.
I don't think perplexed. Either of us is willing to give up the Cammy title.
No, I kind of... I've had it for a while now. I kind of like it.
I like it too. Yeah.
I just think that, you know, we're... You know how other people have the Mike name?
Mm-hmm.
So I think that... You know, that may happen to him, but it's more unique in our case because it's Cammy.
We'll just have to live with it. We'll learn to deal with it.
That's right. So where are you from and why are you trying to relocate to Portland?
I'm from California. And the reason I'm trying to get out of California is because we have schizophrenic weather, for one thing. And for another thing.
So you want to move to Portland, Oregon? Yeah.
Our weather is lovely year-round.
Yeah, do you like that? Except, you know, at least it's consistent. This is what I say.
It is consistently.
It's consistently rainy, mm-hmm. Right?
So, except for in the summer.
Right. Then, yeah. So we're thinking about relocating because the cost of living is better. Weather's consistently rainy, except for the summer. And so that there'll be two Cammies in one town.
Mm. That's good stuff.
Mm-hmm.
All other Cammies must leave Portland.
Yes,
now.
If there are any.
Yeah, I'm sure there has to be another Cammy somewhere in Portland, and she needs to leave now.
Mm-hmm.
I have a friend who has a little boy named Cameron, and she calls him Cammy sometimes, and it's always in this, Cammy, you stop that.
Oh, what did I do?
And you always turn around.
I do every time. You've seen it.
Yeah.
You've seen it happen. It's always very...
Keaton's middle name is Cameron.
Oh, yeah. See? Don't call him Cammy.
No, I won't. Won't
Keaton OC I know who Keaton is. He knows who Keaton is. Does everyone know who Keaton is? Keaton is probably one of the cutest babies in the entire world.
Isn't he cute? I can say that because I had absolutely nothing to do with it.
He's adorable.
He's a very cute kid.
He's absolutely adorable.
He's starting to smile a lot now, which is very fun.
Aww.
I know. He's got a great smile. Big dimples. And it's the first time I'm away from him.
It's scary.
I know.
And you can sleep.
And I slept last night. I slept for like a brick for like 8 hours. It was great.
That's nice.
We mm-hmm. saw some photographs mm-hmm. of him. And the first thing I noticed is he had like the same type of photographs that baby Kay had at that age. You had like these little swaddling in these photographs, and it was like, it just looks like Kay. So we have similar photographs too. So not only doppelganger, same name, you have very similar baby photographs to our baby Kay photographs.
They looked similar too, though. It wasn't just that it was the, you know, bath towel photo and stuff. They just looked similar. He's a thin baby. He was mm-hmm, little.
Very thin baby.
And I'm used to like the big, pudgy, chunky, cheeky babies. Mm-hmm. Kay was not a pudgy, cheeky baby at all. She was a very tiny little baby. So it's so interesting to see it. And she's like, oh, he's so cute.
He is cute. Yeah. But that's funny. See, the doppelganger-ness continues.
It goes to Bakersfield, and as we recently, Hanford, we found out as well.
Mm-hmm. Now, what's up with that?
Susan's family is from Hanford.
And my parents' family from Hanford.
I was in Hanford at Christmas.
Did you go to Superior Dairy?
I did not, but they have the best ice cream ever. We were going to go and get the wintertime maple. It's like the maple pecan.
Oh, I know.
Didn't make it there.
That's very sad. I have to say, for all the Northwest listeners, that's Hanford, California.
Oh, yeah, not Hanford with the...
Hanford, Washington, the national nuclear dump site.
Not the nuclear dump site. No. Hanford, California. California, not Washington. Sorry. Yes. Should have clarified.
Because then both Cammies would have two heads.
Oh, that'd be four Cammies.
It'd be like Zaphod Beeblebrox, you know? It'd be like...
Awesome. We haven't watched that movie in a while. I love that movie. I love that
reference
book.
Reference to Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy.
Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy.
Douglas Adams. May he rest in peace.
Is he really dead?
Don't get me started.
Are we playing the dead game, or is he really dead?
When they made the movie at the end, they actually tried to remember. Okay. He died before the movie.
You're right. You're right. So. He did. I remember seeing the thing at the end for Douglas.
I think.
Mr. Chaos notoriously kills people before they're actually dead. He doesn't kill them.
Right.
But he thinks they're dead, and then I have to go and...
No, they haven't died yet.
No. I have to prove it, too. I have to find it on IMDb or something and... Look it up. But in this case, I think he's correct. I think I remember them saying at the end that Douglas Adams had passed.
So why is it that you think people are dead often? Because you don't see them?
Because I'm weird? don't know. I really don't know.
Older people.
Usually what happens is someone dies and it's in the news that a person died. And I'm like, I thought that person died like 3 years ago, you know?
Yeah.
Except for Abe Vigoda, who will never believe is dead, because Abe Vigoda is still alive. You know who Abe Vigoda is?
I don't.
He was on Barney Miller.
Don't jinx this, please.
Abe Vigoda, we want you to live a long, healthy life.
All of a sudden, are you sure?
If he passes, I will feel like a really guilty individual.
I heard something about that.
Would you stop it? You're not Eddie Izzard. You're not Eddie Izzard. It's not Engelbert Humperdinck and something schlapped you back.
Blah. Hanford and Bakersfield?
Hanford and Bakersfield, and we're both Cammies.
What's in Bakersfield? What are you guys...
I lived in Bakersfield for several years.
I was born in Bakersfield and lived there for several years.
Wow.
Yeah, as a child.
Mm-hmm. This is getting
I lived there as a child. She was born there as a child.
As a child.
Coincidentally.
I was born as a child, yes. Yeah, the doppelganger-ness is scary. And see, these little facts have just barely just been, you know, uncovered slowly through the...
Correct.
Through the, you know, there since could we've be been more. Blogging, there could be more, yes.
We both wore the same general black mid-length sleeve shirt, dark wash jeans. I'm not wearing my Converse right now. The one good thing is that her Converse have white. My Converse have pink stars.
I have a question.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Cammy.
Curse you, Mr. Chaos!
Which one of us?
Do you have any tattoos?
Oh, that's definitely your question.
I think the answer would be yes if either one of us answered it.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Mm-hmm. More doppelganger-ness.
Do.
Yes. I have a few.
Well, there you go.
Secret. Mm-hmm. What's that from?
I don't know.
There was some show.
A commercial for Underarm.
No.
For women? Strong Enough for a Man, Made for a Woman?
Made for a Woman.
This podcast is brought to you by Secret. Strong Enough for a Man, but Made for a Woman. Cami Chaos, Secret.
Do I use Secret?
Someone give us money.
Please, we love money.
Money.
Mm-hmm. Let Mr. Chaos retire from his, you know, large conglomerate. Mm-hmm. Not that we don't love you, large conglomerate that pays our bills. Right.
So
Moving on.
I'm a little bit handicapped here because I cannot reach the champagne.
Oh, no, I'll get it. Hold on.
Okay.
That should be my job, right?
Thank you. Ah, perfect.
Now I can get back behind the microphone. We have mimosas.
So you've been to Portland before?
I have been to Portland before. It's been a couple of years.
Have you seen enough of Portland so far? I know you're trying to.
I haven't seen enough of it. Hmm. I think I've seen one side of the river. I haven't seen the other side.
So you've not really seen the west side?
I don't think so, not very much. But I really like the neighborhood that you guys live in. It's nice.
Thank you.
It's kind of what we're looking for if we move. You know, community involvement, nice mm-hmm. walk to stuff.
I'd be happy to show you more of it when we're done with our podcast in Mimosa.
Perfect.
We can go see the local bar.
It's always nice when there's a local bar.
That's not a joke. Okay. I'm not joking. It's sad. That's really sad, but it's Saturday, and I've started drinking early, so.
Who knows?
It's just sad. Yeah, that's sad.
So what else do we have on the agenda?
Yeah, we've been eating and stuff more than we've been contemplating the podcast. So poor all of you who sat down and actually tried to listen to this. Mm-hmm. We're not very prepared today. We had Christmas cards. We had, is it difficult to talk to someone with your own name? I'm recapping here.
Maybe Cami has something. Cami?
What do I have to talk about? I don't know. I'm enjoying my trip to Portland. We've discussed that already, though.
Yeah. I've enjoyed my trip to Portland, too. It's lasted quite some time.
How long have you been blogging?
A year.
Oh,
did we start around the same time?
Doppelgangers.
Mm-hmm. Oh, no. We started... Oh.
I know. It's scaring me.
What's month?
I think December.
Okay.
See, those... Okay.
I started in November.
We're starting to creep ourselves out.
I started, I think, halfway through November. This is not...
My first post was the 1st of December, I think.
What was your first tattoo of?
My first tattoo is of a daisy, because I like daisies.
Okay, we're safe.
It's on my ankle.
Oh, no! My first tattoo is also on my ankle.
You see?
It was not a daisy, though. It's the creepiness.
It is creepy.
It's the super creepiness. Oh, my goodness. Mm-hmm. Oh, and our children both have a name that starts with the letter K.
Right.
It's not getting less creepy.
I had to tell you something odd. I did not know K's name.
Mm-hmm.
And I won't spill K's name, but tell you that her name was what I was going to name my daughter, except I was going to not have the...
Uh-huh, I know exactly. Yeah. The flourish at the end.
Yes, mm-hmm. Because... I'll tell you why, but I won't say my parents' names because that will.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
But my parents, I was going to name my mother has the first part of her name, and my father has the last part of her name.
That's nice.
So that isn't that. Yeah, when
I know exactly now what your parents' names are.
Yes, you do. So when I got here and heard you say her name, mm-hmm. I almost fell on the floor. It's like
creepy doppelganger people. My parents' names are not that. Do we know my dad's name? We know my dad's name. My dad's name is Bob.
Daddy Chaos.
But it's Daddy Chaos. Yeah. And it would have been funny if I named her anything having to do with the word Bob.
That would have been funny. It was very hard for me to just say that whole bit right there without mm-hmm. saying names.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's really the only part of the name we care about is hers. Is the
audience is scratching their head going,
huh? They're going, what?
You're a bunch of crackheads. Why am I listening to you?
Essentially for the audience, she almost named her kid the same name.
As our kid. We could discuss Cami's drunk dialing last night.
Oh, yes. I did some of that last night.
Not my drunk dialing.
A little bit of drunk dialing. So, go ahead. You can. No.
Oh, I was on my computer around 9:30, and I was talking to Cami for a few minutes. And then I had been drinking champagne. She was going to come over last night and have dinner, but her day was very long, so we offered to have her come over today instead. To which she said, I'm so tired. Thank you.
Yes.
You kind, kind people. Mm-hmm. And then she woke up apparently from her tiredness and started dialing for alcohol, I think, at 9:30 at night. And I talked to her for a minute, but then I shut down my computer and turned off my ringer.
Yes.
And when I woke up this morning, there was emails and phone calls.
Yes.
And I was like, oh my God, I hope everything's... Oh, you're just drunk. Okay, that's fine.
It was just drunk dialing.
That's fine. That's okay, it was with me.
It was a cute little, like a just burst of energy on my ridiculously expensive wine at the hotel.
Mm-hmm.
And then, nobody could play with me. Everyone was sleeping, and so I went to sleep, which was better for all of us, I think.
Probably. Although everyone should know, if you come to Portland, don't expect to go to your hotel bar and drink the wine. It's going to be very expensive.
Yeah.
Stop the grocery store, buy yourself a bottle.
Yes, it was the $8 glass of wine that I had. It was a little spendy.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I recommend Mad Dog 2020 in a bag. No, I really don't.
No. No.
If our wine guy listens to this podcast, he's going to be ashamed. He's like, oh, God, now I know I haven't seen Mike in a while.
Yeah, that's why they don't come anymore. Mike's degraded himself to the Mad Dog 2020. Express. Sorry, BB. He really doesn't drink the Mad Dog. We just need a new babysitter.
Not since 20 years ago in a rock band where I had one once.
Yeah.
And never had it again.
I don't think I've ever consumed it.
I have not.
Have you ever told someone, I can't feel my feet?
Yes, I have, but not in that context.
That was the context that I told someone. Actually, it was a girl.
Of course it was.
Who kissed me, and I responded by saying, I can't feel my feet.
Which was exactly the reaction she was looking for, I'm sure.
I'm sure it was. Maybe she thought she had mad kissing skills.
Yeah.
Next subject.
So, have you ever had Strawberry Hill?
Yeah.
Oof. That's like a Bakersfield thing, though.
Yeah, I think so.
It is.
Because, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And are you kind of in a wine country area down there? I mean, a lot of California. Which area?
So we're by, there's a lot of wineries in Santa Barbara and San Ynez.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
The San Ynez is really close to us in Los Olivos. So I think that I'm blanking on the name, that wine movie name.
The one with Sideways.
Sideways.
Yeah.
Some that was filmed in some of the wineries in the area. Mm-hmm. So yeah, there's some good wineries up there.
Wasn't it? It was supposed to take place in Napa, though, right?
It did take place in Napa, but I think I haven't seen
they
the movie.
They kind of mixed it up.
I always think it's funny when they do that, where they're like, "This is, this goes in is in Napa," but then they go and film it somewhere else.
Isn't there a cameo in that movie?
Mm.
I've heard that there is, and she's not a very nice person.
Is there?
You might be right. You might be right.
I would have.
Was it the girl that he was going to marry?
I don't know because I haven't seen it. But somebody told me that there was a cameo in that movie.
Oh, so you haven't seen Sideways?
Oh,
really?
I have seen
it. Cute movie.
I haven't seen it.
It's good.
It is.
It's got one of my favorite actors in it.
Which is?
Paul. Paul Giamatti.
I was going to help you with that.
Thank you. You're so nice, baby. But it's not because of that. He did a movie called The Illusionist.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the best, and don't laugh at me, people, some of the best cinematography I've seen is towards the beginning of that movie, and it's Paul Giamatti walking down this hallway, and just the way it's filmed and the look on his face is just, it was just such a powerful film moment for me. I love him anyway, but I really, in that movie specifically.
I have to check it out.
Yeah, good movie.
So what movies do you like?
I like all kinds of movies. When I was in school, I did a stint with film noir. I studied that for a while.
Yay, film noir.
We love
Cammy
loves film noir as well. Don't you, Cammy?
Doppelganger.
Which Cammy am I talking about? So two of the films that you and I started watching that you love and we always bring it up sometimes is Notorious.
One of my very, just very
Alfred
favorite
Hitchcock.
Top three film films noir. Of all times.
And of course The Maltese Falcon, one of the greatest film noir
ever.
Ever. Just great movies.
Yeah.
So she likes film noir.
Oh, and we both have wool coats, but that's neither here nor there.
Yes.
Yours is very nice. It's red. I like red.
Oh, okay.
Kay pointed that out when I got here.
Yes.
She said, your coats are the same material.
Kay likes to point things out. She also pointed out that you were the first blogger to ever use the coat rack.
She did. Yes.
Yes. Which brings us to the fact that Cammy's the first blogger that I didn't know before they blogged that I've met. Well, except for the Metro Blog people, who actually are real humans and they do count. But That was different because it was a Metroblog get together. But Cammie's the first. It's hard to say her name. Cammie's the first out of town blogger that I didn't know already that I've ever met. Mm-hmm. And I could have met her in June mm-hmm. when we were in Disneyland. Mm. Except for we were so horribly overscheduled. So the only blogger I've ever met and the only blogger I've ever had a chance to meet twice, same person.
That would be the same for me.
Damn! Curse you, doppelganger.
Yep.
Creepy doppelganger stuff.
So what other interests?
Right now, sleep is a big interest because I'm not getting a lot of it. Susan and I are big outside people. We have dogs and we walk and we bike and we do stuff like that.
This would be a good neighborhood for that, mm-hmm. by the way.
For lots of everyone dogs. In this neighborhood has a dog and
except
a kid.
Except us.
Except us, which is sad. Yeah. I want a dog.
Dogs are fun.
Yeah. And back on the dog wanting, honey. You don't want to talk to me for a while.
Doggy wash. A lot of doggy.
There's like dog daycares. There's down the street. Did you see the, I think it's called Roxy's or something? Mm-hmm. Huge doggy boarding. And then there's at least two doggy grooming stores in the neighborhood. There was a dog boutique, but it closed up shop.
Hmm. And one of the parks down by the river has kind of a dog area down there. Cool.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, we like to entertain. Mm-hmm. I haven't been doing a lot of that lately with the baby. Mm-mm. But I like to cook and have people over and drink and be merry.
What was that?
What was that? Did she say something? What else? You know, I like to blog and read blogs.
Doppelganger. Why don't you suggest some subject matter, baby?
I got nothing.
I got nothing. Cam, you got anything?
What do you got?
I got nothing.
It seems like this would be a great place to end the podcast then.
It does.
Yeah. Mm. Let's say goodnight, everybody, even though it's afternoon. Goodnight, everybody.
Goodnight, everybody.
Goodnight.